Hi, we'll be back. If it's your first time to watch my videos, welcome. Today we are going to discuss Tally. Tally is an accounting software for those businesses that are seeking to grow or are growing in volume. They may need to computerize their accounting systems, and the best way to go is by using Tally, as we're going to see shortly. Now, right here on the screen is the question that I wanted to work out. I'm going to read through it very shortly and then we can start. So let's follow. Libya Oil Uganda Limited, 14 out of 28 Street, Industrial Area, Kampala, Uganda. Here box that Kampala, Uganda is a company which deals in petroleum products. The products attract a VAT of 18%. The company's financial year ends on 31st December of every year. Following the increase in the volume of business, the company decided to computerize its accounting systems with effect from 1st January 2019 using Tally accounting software. The following is an extract of its final accounts for the year ended 31st December 2008. So, down here they are showing us the balance sheet for Libya Oil Uganda Limited. I'm not going to go through it because we shall go through it later on. So let's scroll down. The following are notes that relate to the balance sheet above. We shall also get back to that. Continue. Next, we have some additional information here. I'm not going to go through it now because it's really long and we shall get back to it. So let's skip that until the question right here. Assume or do the following to capture the above information using Tally. That's the first step. Then two, create the company in your names and registration number as the address. Next, all transactions are VAT exclusive and the VAT rate is 18%. Now what do they mean by this number three here that all transactions are VAT exclusive? That means VAT was not deducted from the transactions they gave us, so we have to deduct it ourselves. I hope that's clear. Now, 4, units of currency are UDX, Ugandan, shilling. 5, use same as your username or name of administrator and your surname as password. Now, note, remember to place your Tally folder in your folder at the desktop or to save your work in your folder at the desktop. Now, after reading through this, we are going to open our Tally software. Now, just so you know, Microsoft and whatever Windows you use or operating system, it does not come with Tally, so you have to purchase it or install it or whatever. So I'm going to open Tally right here. So we're going to double click and wait for it to load. Now, after Tally loading, this is what you're seeing on the page. That is what it looks like. Now, before we go any further, I'm going to show you a few things that you're going to need while working out this number. First of all, you have to know how the buttons on the keyboard, in case you don't. This is for those who are seeing Tally for the first time. So we're going to open an on-screen keyboard here to make things clear. Now, the first button we're going to look at is the backspace button. It's very important. It's right here. On some computers it appears with the word backspace, but on some others it's just an X right here. This backspace button will help you go back to the previous step in case you missed something or you made a mistake. So press backspace and you go back to the previous step. Now the next button we have is the enter button, which is right here written on enter. Enter button helps you go to the next step, progress within Tally. And then the next button, we have the escape button right here, escape button. Now, escape button can help you leave a page in Tally. If you want to quit that page and go back or somewhere, you can use escape and other reasons. Then we have the end button. End button is right here. Now, the end button will help you go to the end of a text so that you can type something at the end of that text. Something like that. Then next we have the cursor button. The cursor buttons are these ones. This is the upper cursor, downer cursor button, the left and the right. These ones will help you move throughout Tally. Just move up, down, left, right, like that. Now, when that is clear, I can close this and then we can start on our number. Now, once you reach here, you're going to use the cursor buttons to move down until you reach here to work in education mode. So we're going to go down till we reach work in education mode. So let's go. There, once you reach there, you press enter. Now, when you press enter, they bring for you silver edition mode and gold edition mode, which is silver for single user. Now, remember they told us to create our name, our company, to create a company with our name, names as the name of the company and our registration number as the address. So, once you reach here, you're going to select company, go down up to create a company. Then you press enter. After doing that, now you can see Tally has brought us here to name. But remember, we have to first save our work in this part of directory. So we want to go back to the previous step. And like I said, to go back to the previous step, you press backspace. So we're going to press backspace. Now remember, I also told you that to type something at the end of a text, you have to press end. So we need to give a name to our work so that you can easily find it. And now you can see that the directory here shows C. That means in order to locate where you'll save your work, you're going to go to local disk C, then user, then public, then tally.erp9, then data. That is where you'll find your work. So you're going to press N, and then you can save your work as what you want, so that you can easily find it. So I'm going to save it as my surname, that's the word, tutorial. Now, after that, to go to the next step, we just press enter. Now we can type in our name comfortably. Full name, if you may. Yes, once you're done, you press enter. Mailing name, we'll go to mailing name. Mailing name, the name has come automatically. Now we say to put our address as the registration number. Now you can put your address as your registration number. Yes, now that's not my registration number, but you can put your registration number. So you press enter and then enter again. Then they'll bring you to statutory compliance. Now, when you're in statutory compliance, there's a window they've opened here that shows you that list. So you're going to go up by pressing the upper cursor button until you reach none up here. Then you press enter. We don't have any statutory compliance. Telephone number, you fill in your telephone number, whatever it is. And mobile number and also email. You can fill in your email. Press enter. Enable auto backup. If you're in a paper, enabling auto backup is useless. So we just leave it at no. So we press enter. Now they brought us up here. And they're asking for currency symbol. The currency symbol is VGX, as we saw in the question. Let me make that capital VGX. Then you press enter. Now we go here to maintain. They're asking maintain accounts with inventory or accounts only. You stick to accounts with inventory and press enter. Now financial. What was our financial? Yeah, we can go back to the question and see the financial. Yeah, I think it was written up at the beginning, the balance sheet. As you can see, this question is very long, so you have to do it really fast. Now, counting systems will keep it from 1st January 2019. So that's what we fill in. 1st January 2019. So 1st/January/2019. Enter. Then books beginning from zero. You leave that value. Press enter. Tallyboard password. This is where you fill in the password they told you. They told us to fill in the password as our surname. Now make sure these passwords are caps lock sensitive. Like if you do your password in capital letters, leave it as that. You save it as small letters, remember that. So you type your surname, press enter. Then they're asking us to repeat password. So we do that. But you can see there is a warning, forgetting your password will render your data unusable. So make sure you don't forget. Use security control. Just use no. Press enter. Now, best currency symbol we are down here is still UGX. The formal name they told us is Ugandan shilling. Then you press enter. The number of decimal places remain at zero. Enter. Is symbol suffix to amounts? Leave this as no. Don't tap over here. Show amount in millions right here. Yes. That's what we want. Put a space between amount and symbol. This is unnecessary, so it's no. Decimal places for printing remain at zero. Press enter. Now once you press enter, it will bring that window. Accept. Yes, of course you want to accept this work. So you can either click on yes or you can press Y for yes. Then we are done. Then we can type in our Talibot password. Now from here onwards up to the end of this number, our work is going to be saved automatically. You don't need to go back and save it, alright? Yeah. So now we've created our company in our names. Now we can go and start answering the question. So the first thing you do once you reach here is to fill in the stroke items. Now you're going to go to here to inventory info. Press enter. Now stock, remember stock items have units. The stock items have units. So you have to first create the units of menu. Right there. Then you press enter. Then create right here. Now we're going to go back and see what our stock items and their units are. So you can see here on note 2 we have inventory. And these are our stock items. Premium, super, hydraulic, brake fluid, coolant. And these are the units that we want. The units, we only have liters and kilograms. And these are their formal names. So that is what we are going to fill in. Go back. Now what is that symbol? We have LTR. And the formal name is liter. Press and number of decimal places is 0. Accept. Yes. Now the other unit we had was kgs. And what is the formal name? Kilogram. Like that. Number of measures. Yes. So there are no more units of measure. If you do not create those units of measure, you're going to find problems ahead. So we are going to press escape because we want to go back to the previous window. Escape. Then you press yes. You want to click yes. Again, escape. Now we've created the units of measure. Once you reach this window, we are going to fill in the stock item. So go back, go up and fill and press enter. Single stock item, yes. Create. Now the name, we are going to start filling in the stock items. The first item name is premium, super, and its units are liter. So we fill in premium, super. Super. Then you press enter until you reach under, right here. Under is primary, sticky primary. Then you press enter. The units, we say the units for premium super are liters, so go down to liter and press enter. Set standard rates. Now, if your computer is not showing this part of set standard rates, then you just know you have to configure some values. Now to configure so that this part appears, you're going to go down. You're going to come to this, the right hand side of the thing. Then you look for configure down here, F12. Now when configure comes, you're going to, in order for the, your window to show standard rates, you're going to see here down, allow standard rates for stock items. Press enter until you reach that and make sure you set it to yes. If yours is on, no. But in case yours is on yes, leave it. Press enter, enter, and it will come. So set standard rates, we are back here. Change that note to yes. Just type it, yes. Press enter. Now this is another window. They want us to fill in this form. Now applicable form, don't change the date, leave that, press enter. The rate, they're asking us for the rate of the standard cost. So we go back to the question, what is the standard cost for premium super? This is the standard cost, which is 48,000. So you fill that in. 48,000 per The units come automatically. If you did not create the units of measure, this part will be empty, which is really sad. Now press enter and then enter again so that it comes to this side. Press enter, skip that. Now the rate for the standard selling price, what is the rate? It is 75,000. 75,000. Then you press enter, the units appear, enter again, enter. Then you come back. Now the rate of duty, what did they tell us our rate of duty was? Right here, they told us our rate of duty was 18%. So that's how to fill in. Let's have to fill in 18. Now the opening balance, what's the opening balance of premium, super? Oh, we have quantity. Under opening balance, we have quantity. What is the quantity? Go back to the question. Now the quantity is 40. 40 liters. That's what we're feeling. 40. And then the rate. Now stock is valued at the standard cost by the prudence principle. The prudence principle states that we do not anticipate profits, but we provide for losses. Now if you put the selling price here at the rate, then you are not following the prudence principle. So here you put the standard cost or the cost price. So we look, standard cost was 48,000. That's the value you put. 48,000. Press enter. The PAR comes automatically and the value calculates itself. Then you press yes and accept. So one item is done. Now the remaining items I'm just going to rush through. Next we have hydraulic, it's in liters and it's also 40 liters. Hydraulic. Enter, it's under primary units, liters, external rates, yes. Applicable, the rate, let's look for the rate very fast. 19,000 and then 25,000. 19,000 here. Enter, 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 enter. Then 25. Yes, rate of duty is 18, quantity we said it's 40, the rate was 19,000, enter, 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 accept, yes, hydraulic is done. Now we're going to do brake fluid, it's also liters, 40 liters. Enter, 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 liters, 600 rates, yes, enter, enter, what are the values, like 10,000 and 13,000, so we have 10,000 here, then right here we have 13,000, enter, rate of duty is 18, quantity is 40 still, rate is 10,000. And we deal with the last stock item, which is coolant. Coolant is in kilograms. Quantity is 152. Coolant. Primary, it's in kilograms. Yes. Enter. Enter. So the rate is 5,000, then 10,000. 5,000. Enter. Then 10,000, enter, rate of duty is 18, quantity is 152 kilograms, and the rate still remains 5,000, enter, 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 then accept. So now we finished filling in the stock items, so we are going to press escape until we reach that well, tally, escape, press yes, repeat, escape, escape. So we finished filling in the inventory info. Now we are going to the accounts info. Press enter, the very first one. Enter. The accounts info we are going to fill in is ledgers. So come here to ledgers. Enter. We are going to create the single ledger. Create. Enter. So we are going to bring this window. Now when they bring this window, you go back to the question. Now we are going to fill in item all the items in the balance sheet, as you can see, starting with the assets. Now, under assets, we have the first one, non-tangible, non-current asset. We have land. So we are going to fill in land. So we're going to fill in land. Let's fill in very fast. So the name here is land. Let's enter, enter. Now, once you see this window, this door, whoops, land is what kind of account? It is a fixed asset. So you go down until you see fixed asset. Inventory values are affected? No. Enter. Now that's asking us for the opening balance of land. Let's see what it is. It's 9,258,000. 9,258,000. Enter. Now, most fixed assets most of the time have a debit balance. So debit balance, this is DR, so we leave it at that. Press enter and then yes to accept. So we have finished filling in land. Next we have property, plant and equipment. And in our balance sheet they're telling us here, note, refer to this note. But now you can see that we have note 2 appearing 2 times. So I made a mistake in this question, this is supposed to be note 1. Yes, so property, plant and equipment, you're going to find it on note 1. So scroll down until you see note 1. Note 1 is right here. Note 1, tangible and current asset. The first item is furniture and fittings, and the Venus are of course, and its accumulated depreciation and net book value. Now we're going to fill in these things separately. We are first going to fill in furniture and fittings at cost, then we're fill in furniture and fittings at accumulated depreciation, because the cost account and the accumulated depreciation account are two different accounts. We cannot make them one. So we're going to start with furniture and fittings at cost. So name, right there you fill in furniture and fitting. So you can put a slash here and write cost. Press enter, enter. Now these items are still under fixed assets, but these are tangible fixed assets, so we leave it at fixed assets. Inventory values are affected, no. Opening balance. Opening balance put the cost, which is 21,120,000. 21,120,000. Press enter. Now cost has a normal debit balance, so we leave the DR there. Press here. So after doing that, now we're going to record the furniture and fittings slash accumulated depreciation. Like I said, they are different accounts, so you create them differently. Press enter, enter. Now this one is still under fixed assets, but fixed assets with a credit balance. The other one had a debit balance, this one has a credit balance. So you press enter. Inventory values are affected? No. Enter. Opening balance is probably here, 7 million. 7 million. Press enter. Now we're going to change this DR to CR to main credit. Enter and then accept. Now this second one I'm going to do it very fast because it's the same idea. Machinery cost. Asset. Opening balance 39,794,000. Like that. So this is debit. Accept, yes. Then we record machinery accumulated. Sorry. Depreciation. First, enter, enter. Fixed asset, yes. But no. Opening balance is 11,324,000. 11,324,000. Enter. This is credit. on its depreciation and increase. Yes. So we go back to our balance sheet up. We are filling them in order. So our next thing is intangible non-current assets. The first one, we have goodwill. Now, intangible current assets are mainly goodwill, trademark, patent, and can't bring any of those. So we are going to fill in goodwill. Up there, goodwill. Goodwill, what kind of, it's under, these intangible non-current assets are under investments. So go down to investments first, enter. Inventory values are affected, no? Opening balance of goodwill is 360,000, right there. 360,000. Enter. Debit balance, yes. Enter. Accept. Our next one is trademarks. Are 2,440,000. Investment, no. 2,440,000, right? And debit balance, yes. Accept. Now, after doing that, we are going to now the current assets. First current asset we have inventory, which is that not, but remember we already filled in our stock items as inventory, so we don't need to go back there. Now our next is accounts receivable or debtors. So we go and look for accounts receivables. What note did they say? Accounts receivables, note 3. So we look for note 3. Note 3 is right here. So our first data is Kampala University. Box 1, Dawa. So we fill right here. Name, Kampala. Enter. Enter. Now, these data are under what they call Sandy data. Right there. Right here. Sandy data. Enter. Maintain balance of bill by bill. No, please. Enter. Inventory values are affected. No. Enter. Now, they're asking for the address. So we go look for the address. It's box 1, GABA. So we come here and fill in our box 1, GABA. So we're going to type box 1, enter, then GABA. Like that. Then you press enter, 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 enter. Now the opening balance is 511,000. Enter. Now the debtors also have a debit balance, so just click enter and then accept. Now we go through the remaining debtors very fast. Save time, Boko Boko Hardware Center Limited. Center Limited. Enter. Now these are still debtors. No, no. Now the address is Box 52, Masaka. Box. Enter, 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 enter. Fill in the opening balance, which is 891,000. Next is between the import and export ink box for the company. In the import and export ink. Box 44, Kampala, 186,000. Debit, accept, yes. Next is Mahindo Enterprises. enter. Sorry, better no address is box 241 Iganga. Box 241 Iganga. Enter, filling the opening balance 542,000. Enter the delete balance, yes. Next we have Gulu University, box 7062, Gulu. Enter. Fill in the opening balance 846,000. Enter the list, yes. We go to the next. We're going to go back to the question and go to the next part of the balance sheet. After account receivables or data, we have insurance to pay of 900,000. Now we're going to fill in insurance to pay. Now insurance to pay is under, it's under current assets. So we're going to fill in as current assets first. Enter. No. Opening balance is 900,000. Enter. Debit. Yes. Current assets have a debit balance. Enter. Then you accept. Next. We have bank and cash balances on note 4. So we're going to go down to note 4. So here are our bank and cash balances. We're going to fill in all these banks and their addresses and their balances right there. So we're going to start with Exim Bank. Enter. Exim Bank is under bank account. So look for bank accounts here in the list of oops, and then bank accounts. Enter. Effective date of reconciliation, as you can see, there's something we've highlighted there. Just click enter, which is our date. Set or alter checkbooks, no. Alter banking configuration, no. Enter. Exim Bank address. Let's see if they give us an address. Yeah, they gave us Chireka branch and an account number 498211. So we're going to go to here 498211. Then the branch name is Chireka branch. Enter. What is the opening balance? 1,963,000. 1,963,000. Enter. Until you accept. Now after Exim Bank, we're going to have NC Bank, Makawa branch, NC Bank. Enter, it's under bank accounts, that, account number 662314, Makawa branch, 662314. Press enter, then this is Nakawa for branch name. Enter. Opening balance is 440,800. Enter. Yes. Debit balance. Yes. Next is Equity Bank for a small branch. Enter. Bank account, yes. Account number is 578755 for a small branch. 578755. The branch name is Forest Mall. Enter. Fill in the opening balance, which is 136,200. Enter. Debit balance, yes. Accept. We continue with our balance sheet. as you can see, you're given limited time in the paper, so you have to really read fast and make sure you complete this at least within 40 minutes, even if it looks impossible. So we are done with the assets. Now we're going to the capital and reserves. So the first item here is share capital of that amount. So we're filling share capital. Enter, enter. Share capital is under capital account. Enter. Inventory values are affected, no. Address, no. Capital has no address. So the opening balance will be 37,492,000. Enter. Yes, this is where you start filling in the credit balances, because usually things that are in capital and liabilities are credit accounts. So CR for credit. Enter. Accept. Yes. So share capital is done. We go to the next. Retained earnings. Now our retained earnings have a value there that is in brackets. That means it is a negative value. So instead of having a credit balance as it usually has, that means it is having a debit balance. That means instead of a profit, a loss was made. That kind of thing. So we're going to fill in retained earnings. Enter, enter. Now retained earnings are under reserves and surplus. It's there. But some people may put them under retained earnings. You can put it for psychological satisfaction. But even if you put it under reserves, you still correct. Enter. Inventory value is affected, no. Enter. 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 No address. So what's the opening balance? It is 6,966,400. 6,966,400. Now, like we said, retained earnings usually have a credit balance, but since they have brackets, they are negative, which is comes debit, DR. Enter, then accept. Next, we have general reserves of that amount, 4,096,000 general reserves. Enter, enter. They are also under reserves and surplus. Enter until you reach the opening balance, which is 4,096,000. These have a credit balance. Enter, accept. We go to the next. We have non-current liabilities, and the first one is long-term lease obligation. So we fill that in. Like that. And now these are under loans or liability, right? There. Enter. Inventory values are affected, no. Enter. Enter. There is no address. Now the opening balance is 7,382,400. They also have a credit balance. Accept. Go to the next. We have notes payable of this amount. Notes payable of 19,332,000. These are also under loans and liabilities. Enter. Enter until you reach the opening balance. I think that was it. 19,332,000. Yes. Enter. Credit balance. Yes. Accept. So next, we go to next, we're going to the current liabilities. First, current liabilities, we have our accounts payable, creditors that are telling us to go to note 5. So we're going to fill in our creditors, the people who demand us. They sold goods to us and we didn't pay them. So our first one is Has Petroleum. So we're filling Has Petroleum. like that, enter, enter. Now these are under sundry categories, right here. Enter. Maintain balance in bill by bill, no please. Enter, enter, enter. I think there was an address, so you can press done. Box 554, that is. Enter, enter, enter till you reach your opening balance, which in this case, sorry, is 756,400. 756,400. Credit balance is, creditors have a credit balance. Now we have Total Uganda Limited, box 249, Kampala. Enter. Still leave this box 249, Kampala. Enter. Till you reach here. Fill in this value, which is 363,000. Enter. Credit balance, yes. Accept. Then next, we have Az Energy Tanzania Limited. Az Energy Tanzania Limited. Enter. Enter, enter, enter. What's the address? Box 070, Mwanza, 154, 600. 070. Enter. So you reach the opening balance. And our amount is 554,600. Enter. Credit balance. Yes. Accept. The last creditor, MDG Oils Limited. Enter. Sundry. Creditor. No, no. Address. Box 080, Mombasa. Enter. Till you reach the opening balance, which is 390,000. Credit balance, yes, accept. So our sundry creditors are done. So we can go back to the last part of the balance sheet. So after accounts payable or creditors, we have the accrued expenses. That means there are expenses we don't get paid for, or expenses owing, expenses due, all that. So here we have note 6. Right there, note 6. Expenses owing. We have stationery of 1,045,000. So we're going to fill it in as stationery. Stationery view. Enter. Now these items that are owing, we're going to put them under current liability. Right? There. Enter. Inventory values are affected? No. Opening balance would say it's 1,045,000 if I'm correct. Yes, exactly. Enter. Yes, they have a credit balance. Enter and accept. We fill in the next one. Transport is 509,000. So we're going to fill it in as transport view. Enter. It is 509,000. Enter. Credit balance. Accept. Lastly, salaries and wages 350,000. Enter. 350,000. Credit balance. Enter. Accept. Now, after you finish all these, look at your screen here where you can see my cursor. You can see you have to make sure that these two values are the same. A debit is that and a credit is that. That means you filled in your balance sheet correctly. If not, you just know you've messed up some values, so you have to go back and go through. So, seeing that these values are the same, we can proceed to the next part. So you can press escape. Yes, quit. Escape till gateway of credit. Now before we go ahead, we can view our balance sheet here, right here, download. So you go down until balance sheet, first enter. Now once you reach the balance sheet, in case your balance sheet does not look like mine, you can come down, you can configure it here, F12. So click configure. Now here they are saying show vertical balance sheet, make sure this is set to yes. After setting it, yes, press enter. And you can leave this no, no. Now method of showing balance sheet, make sure it's assets first, then liability. Then you can say enter, enter, then you go back. Now after viewing it like this, you can view the detailed one by clicking here on F1, or you can click out F1. They show you the details here. Now you can compare this balance sheet and make sure it looks like the balance sheet in your question. So we can open our question. You can see our balance here is 65,304,000. Let's make sure that's the same value we have in our balance sheet for the total assets. Right there. 65,304,000. So you're on the right track. We are on the right track. We are doing this together. So after doing that, we have no business here for now. We can escape. So we filled in our accounts and our inventory. Now there are some extra accounts we have to create because we have certain transactions we have to fill in. So go back to account info. Again, ledgers, create. We are still creating ledgers. So we are going to create 3 extra accounts as a must. We have the purchases account. Press enter. Enter. Now purchases account is obviously under purchases account right here down. So we go to it. Press enter. Inventory values are affected. Yes, for purchases and sales, inventory values are affected. Enter. There is no opening balance. Enter. Then accept. Then we're going to create the sales account. Enter. Enter. Sales account is under sales account right there. Enter. Inventory values are affected. Yes. Opening balance is none. Enter and accept. Then we have the VAT. VAT is a must. Remember I said that transactions are VAT exclusive. That means you have to calculate it. You have to deduct it. Enter, enter. Now VAT is under duties and taxes right there. Duties and taxes. Enter. What is the percentage of calculation? It's 18. Enter. Method of calculation, we are going to use tax based on item rate. Enter. There is no opening balance. Enter and then accept. So after creating those 3 accounts, we're going to go back to our question and look if we look for other accounts and additional information. So let's go back. Look for other accounts and additional information that we've not created. We're going to go through very fast to save time. Let's reduce that a little bit. So they are saying all accrued expenses were paid from Exim Bank account. We already created Exim. The following sales were made. We already created Kampala University. We already created Boko Boko. Company received from the following Cobbs Import and Export. I don't think we created any account called Cobbs Import and Export. And this Cobbs Import seems like a data because we received money from them, but we were demanding them, that means they are debtors. So Cobbs Import and Export, we are going to create that account. Cobbs Import and Export. So I'm going to put these ones under Sundry Debtors. Right there. Enter. Maintain balances bill by bill, no. No. We don't have that information. No opening balance, and then yes to accept. We go back, look for more. Company's policy that all receipts banked on Exim. We already created Exim. The following payments were made. Total. We already created Total. purchased 430 items of premium super from Hards Petroleum. We created that. Paid for electricity. I don't think we've created an electricity account yet, so we'll create it very fast. Electricity. Enter. Enter. Now electricity account is under indirect expenses. So right there. Indirect expenses. Enter. No inventory values are not affected. There is no opening balance. Yes, to accept. After doing that electricity, we have NC Bank and Exim. We already finished. 18 purchased motor van. We've not yet created motor van account on credit from Hayat. That means we have a new creditor here, Hayat. And we have to also create the motor van account. So we create those. We have motor van. The motor van is a fixed asset or non-current asset. Inventory value is affected, no. Opening balance, there is none. Then accept. Then we're going to create Hayat. It's Hayat what? Hayat International Uganda Limited. A creditor. Hayat International Uganda Limited. Enter. Enter. Now this is our creditor, so I'm going to put them under Sandy. Creditor right there. Enter. No. No, we don't have address, we don't have opening balance. Yes, next we have cash sales of that amount. Now, for this transaction, we expect to open two accounts, cash account and sales account. But remember, we already opened the sales account. And for cash account, the cash account is created automatically by tariff, so we don't need to create that account, so we skip that. Go to the next. Here we have Exim Bank. Still we have interest on bank deposit of that, so we are going to create the interest received account. Please make sure you create these accounts. If you don't, you won't be able to do the transactions. So interest received account is under indirect income. You can either use that indirect income or there's another one here. Whatever satisfies you. Enter. Inventory values are not affected. There is no opening balance. Accept. Then we have bank charges. So I want to create a bank charges account. Charges. Enter. Enter. Bank charges are under indirect expenses. There. No, we are not affected. No opening balance. Accept. Then we see the last one. Say payment of account of electricity. We already created that. So I believe we've created all the accounts we shall need to do transactions. Also, you can press escape and you quit. Escape until the will tally. So we've done accounts info, we've done inventory info, now we're going to accounting voucher. So press enter, sorry, escape. Go down to accounting vouchers, enter. Now when you reach this part and your window does not look like mine, in other words, it does not have debit or credit, you can come down here and configure. Right here, configure. And then you're going to change a few things. First of all, you're going to change this. Use single entry mode for. If yours is set to yes, make it no. Because our transactions are double entry. For every debit, there is a credit. That is a double entry rule. So set this to no. We don't want single entry. Then click enter until you reach here. Use credit or debit instead of two or bad. Set this to yes if yours is saying no, set it to yes. Then press enter until you go back and your window will appear like mine. So once you reach here, now we're going to use our additional information and start filling in the values. So what is the question right here? So we go back up. This is the reason why I didn't put these things at the beginning, because I'm going to read them anyway. 11. All accrued expenses as at 31st December 2018 were paid from Exim Bank. Remember, accrued expenses were these. the expenses only. So all this money, we paid it as at 31st December 28. No, we paid them as at that date. So we're going to go, and then you're going to look in this window right here where you see the account. Since this is a payment, we paid the accrued expenses, then you're going to click here on payment, F5 payment. Mine is already selected. So if we are paying these expenses, remember expenses accounts are debited. They are debit accounts. They increase by debiting. So we're going to put all our expenses on the debit, and then Exim Bank is going to be credited because our bank is losing money as you pay, you're losing money. So the first one we're going to fill in is stationary bill. We're going to pay for that stationary bill. Stationary bill. Enter. So this is the amount due. So that's what we're going to type in here. 1,045,000. You press enter, and then it will bring for you credit. But since you want to do all these accounts at once, so they're all expenses, let's first fill in all of them. So put debit again, and then you put in the next expense, which is transport. Yeah, right there, transport. You can click on it, enter. The amount owing is 509,000. Enter. So we're going to fill in the last one. So still make it debit, enter. Fill in the last thing, which is salaries and wages. There. Salary. Enter. So we're going to fill in the 350,000. Now, as you can see, what shows that we have paid for this thing is current balance shows 0, 0, and also when you press enter here, it will show 0. Now we are going to credit for every debit laser. Credit, click enter. What did they tell us to in our transaction? They were paid from Exim Bank account, so Exim Bank is losing. So click Exim, enter. So Exim Bank is paying that whole amount. Then click enter. Now we have no business here, so press enter here. Till you reach narration, we don't need to put the narration. Click enter and then accept. So our first transaction is done. Next, they're like, the following sales were made to Kampala University. Now remember, Kampala University is one of our data, so we put them on credit. So Kampala University, 30 liters of premium super only, 22 watt delivered. So we're going back to our tally. Look through this window, and since they are saying sales were made, we're going to open sales. So click here on sales, or press F8. So the sales window looks like this. Here in ref, we have no business here. So the party's account name, who is our data? Kampala University, and we sold to them premium super. So Kampala, there you are, enter. Also, we have no business here, so just press enter. Okay. What sales ledger is involved? It's here, the sales account. If you happen to not have created that sales account, you know where to see it here, listed among the list of ledger. So make sure you create it, enter. Name of item is premium super, enter. So what quantity do they sell to them? 30 liters of premium super, only 22 are delivered. So that means you only manage to sell to them 20, to ignore that 30, 22. The rest of the information after here is coming automatically, like the rate, because you already filled it in, liter, amount. Then you press enter. When you press enter, it brings you here. So press enter again. And remember, they said all transactions are VAT exclusive, so we have to include VAT there. So enter. The VAT is calculated automatically. Enter until you accept. Yes. So we are done with that transaction. Now let me do the next one very fast. Boku Boku Hardware is our data. Enter. Boku enter, enter, sales ledger is sales account name. What did we sell to them? 50 kilograms of coolant. So we have coolant as the name of this item. Then 50 kilograms. Red, enter, enter, then VAT, enter, enter until you accept. We go to the next transaction. Very fast. The company received amount due from the following. So the company received, that is a receipt from Cobbs Import. Cobbs is a data, so this is a receipt. So we're going to click here on receipt. That window will open. So we have our data. Now the data's account, the data's account reduces by credit limit. So we're going to put our data here, Cobbs, under credit. And they did what? We received 550,000 from them. So we're going to put 550,000 right there. Enter. Now what account are we going to debit? Let's go back to your question. It is the company's policy that all receipts are banked on Exim Bank account as soon as they are received. So we are going to debit Exim Bank. It is the one receiving the money from. Enter. Enter, enter. No business here, just enter until you accept. Over to the next transaction. Number 14. The company also made the following payments, all from Exim Bank. One, we have total. So this is a payment. So if we have a payment made, that means Exim Bank is being credited, it's losing, and then total is gaining. So total we shall debit total with 200,200. So it is a payment. Debit total with 200,200. And then we are crediting what? Exim Bank. Because you paid from Exim. Enter. Enter until you accept. Next, we have a purchase. Purchased 430 liters of premium super foam Haz Petroleum. So Haz Petroleum is one of our creditors. Creditors increased by crediting. So we are going to credit Haz Petroleum. No, this account has no crediting and debiting. We are going to open purchases. We are going to open right here on this window. Look for purchase. Reference, there is none. Party's account name is Haz Petroleum, and we are purchasing from them premium super. So we have Haz Petroleum, enter. Have the business here, enter. Purchases ledger involved is the purchases account we created that. Name of item is premium super. Premium super. 430 liters. Up to date, only 330 liters have been received. So we fill in the 330 that were received. Enter, that is the red. Enter. Enter again and then fill in the VAT. Enter. Enter until you accept. So we are done with that transaction. We go to the next one. Paid for electricity of 5,300 using NC Bank. That means NC Bank is losing, shall credit NC Bank and debit the electricity account, which is an expense. So this is a payment. Paid. Debit electricity, credit NC Bank. Payment. Debit electricity. With 5,300. And then credit NC Bank. Enter. Enter until you accept. Next, transfer of 150,500 from NC Bank to Exim Bank to cater for general expenses. Now, these kinds of transactions are what we call contra entries. Why contra? Because they entered into the same account, the cash book. They are between the same account, the bank account in the cash book. So it's a transfer from NC to Exim. That means NC Bank is losing 150,500. So we credit it and debit Exim. And this is what we call a contra entry. So we open our tally. Then you come to this window and look for contra right there. So we say which bank is losing NC Bank. So we credit it with 100. What was the amount? 150,500. 500. Enter. And this money is going to Exim. So you debit Exim. Enter. Enter until you accept. Next. An interesting one. 18. Purchased a motor van worth 2.5 million on credit from Hayat. Now, one of the functions of Ajano. Ajano is one of the first book of accounts where transactions are recorded for the first time. Now, one of the functions of Ajano is to record purchases and sales of fixed assets on credit. So once we go to our tally, we are going to open the window for Jano, this one, H7, Jano. So we are going to, what account are we going to debit and which one are we going to credit? If you purchase a motor van, that means the motor van account is going to be debited with 2.5 million, while our creditor Hayat will be credited. So motor van debited with 2.5 million, motor van, 2.5 million. Yes, enter. And we are crediting what? Hayat. That one. Enter until you accept. As easy as that. Next, we have cash sales of coolant to Narwaze. So these are sales made of cash. So we have two accounts here, the cash account and the sales account. Go back and click here on F8 sales. Open that window. Reference, we have none. Enter. Now the party's account name, which is usually the debtor's name. Here we don't have a debtor, instead we have cash. Like I said, Tally creates the cash account automatically. You never need to create it, it comes automatically. Enter. Enter. Now the ledger involved is the sales account, because that is where sales go. Now, name of item. What item did you sell? Coolant of 20 kilograms. Coolant of 20 kilograms. So, item is coolant. Quantity. Quantity is 20 kilograms. Enter. Enter. Then enter again. Fill in VAT. Enter. Enter. Will you accept? Done. Next, according to the bank statement from Exim Bank, the following does not appear in the bank current account. Now, this statement alone shows us that Exim Bank is the bank current account. So, these transactions we have to fill them in the bank current account. We have interest received of 7,200. So we are going to go interest received is a receipt, and we are going to credit it interest received with what amount? With 7,200. Enter. Then we are going to debit the bank current account because the bank received the interest. Enter until you accept. Next. We have the bank charges of 4,300. So we fill those in bank charges. This is a, we're going to consider this as a payment. A payment to the bank. Remember when you have an account in the bank, there's some bank charges is subtract. So it's like a payment to the bank. So we payment. So we're going to debit the bank charges. The following does not appear in the bank current account. bank charges of 4,300. Enter. 4,300. Enter. Enter. Now these bank charges are going to credit XZ Bank. Enter. Enter until you accept. Yes. Good girl. Now our last transaction for the day here. Payment of account of electricity of 2,500. So payment of account of electricity. So it's a payment still. That means you're going to debit electricity for the turn expense. What is the payment of 2,500? And we're using what? Exim Bank. Enter. Enter until you accept. Now we finished filling in all the transactions that we need. So let's press escape and we quit until gateway expires. Now, when you reach this step, let's go back to the question. What are they asking us? Reconcile the bank current account. Now, to reconcile, you're going to go back to your tally and then come down here to display. Display, enter. Then trial balance. Here, enter. Now, this is what our trial balance looks like. We want our trial balance to be detailed. So come here and make it detailed so that we can locate the bank accounts, because we are reconciling the bank accounts. So go down until bank accounts down there. Enter. Now you want us to reconcile the bank current account, which is Exim. So go to Exim, enter. Once you reach here, January, we're going to the financial year starts in January. Enter. And once you reach here, you can see on this window that they put reconcile right here. So all you need to do is to click on reconcile. Once you click on reconcile, they bring for you this window. So we have date, particulars, voucher type, transaction type, instrument number, instrument date. Now the bank date is not given. So you're going to come here to this window and look for save all dates right there. Click on it. And then we want to set all dates to this date. So we don't need to change it, just press enter. And all those dates will be filled in automatically. We have no more business here, so just press enter until you accept. And the reconciliation will be done. To prove whether you've reconciled, you can go back and here click F5 to reconcile. You will notice that this column is now empty. So press escape until you go back to the 12 and we finished answering that question. Then escape. Now you can view your new balance sheet from here. Now as you can see, our totals have changed. Now we have 82,901,000. Here previously it was the balance sheet total was this 65,304,000. Now what else do we have in this question? Here, the note. Remember to place your tally folder in your folder at the desktop, or to save your work in your folder at the desktop. So all we are left with doing is saving our work on a folder at the desktop. That one should be easy. So all we have to do is to go to the desktop and create a folder. So we're going to right click, then go to new, then folder. On your folder, you're going to type your name and whatever information you need to put there, like your registration number. After doing that, you're going to open your local disk C. Now you can open your local disk C by, you can open any folder. Usually when you open any folder, they bring the menu. So look for your local disk C. Mine is right here. Remember where we said the work C, then users, then public, then type ERP9. Then you have to remember how you save your work. I saved mine as this, if you remember well, tutorial. Yeah. Just press copy and then you paste it right here. Paste. Now even if I happen to come back to my work here and I decide to close it, escape, escape, quit. If I want to access it again, I'm gonna have to come here, open my folder, copy this, then go to the Tally software right here, right click and then paste. When you do this, my work will, your work and my work will open automatically, which is exactly what we want. Now in case they've asked you to email your work, you can go back to your folder, right click on it, and then send to, come here to send to, and then compress zip folder. Now for compressed files, you can email them to save, that is the easiest way to do it. So let's see. Yes, so the Tally has already loaded. Now you can go back to Silver. They will ask you for your password again here, so type it in. So you have to make sure you don't forget it. So you can see I've gotten my work back, all of it. Yes, I guess that's it for today. Thank you for joining me. Until next time. Bye.